Okay, so today we have the Housemartins and Think for a Minute. Seems like a little bit of a demanding title, but anyway, it's been a while since I've listened to the Housemartins or reacted to them. Actually, it's been a minute, my goodness. And I think the only song I ever reacted to by them was Happy Hour, and I thoroughly enjoyed that one. So finally, we're back today with Think for a Minute. And anyway, let's get into it, talk about it after. Gonna watch a video here. I don't know if it'll get blocked or not, but anyway, let's see and let's go.
That's it. Something's going wrong, change is taking place. Children smiling in the street have gone without a trace. The street used to be full, it used to make me smile. And now it seems that everyone is walking single file.
We're finished, mate.
Weddings, parties, and private functions. Okay, my gosh. So the Housemartins, and Think for a Minute, of course. my God. So obviously, I have to say at the top, Paul Heaton's voice, or PD Heaton, as he's kind of referred to as well. But Paul's voice is so, I mean, just obviously. Listening to him before, you know, you could tell he has a high tenor, but here he just shows off so well. Obviously such a distinctive voice, so beautiful, so glorious, so, you know, so high, and so, like I said, so distinctive. You can tell, you know, it's Paul Heaton. I mean, my God, it's just like no one has a voice. And just the way, and again, I know it's like lip syncing probably in the video and everything, that he's like sitting on a stool, but, you know, just the way he can control his voice, he can, you know, just sit there, you know, kind of look pretty and just sing like that, and, you know, do it so flawlessly and so beautifully. And I just can't get over his soothing vocals. It's just like, my God. And again, I love the backing vocals here as well. You know, the thing for a minute, stop for a minute. It's just like, oh, just behind him is beautiful as well. And obviously here as well, I like how the video is kind of fun, because the song kind of sounds a little bit depressing, because of course it seems like, you know, longing for the old days is really what I got. I mean, my God, you know, and of course, you know, the whole thing of stop and smell the roses, my dog jumped on the band, scared me. But anyway, stop and smell the roses kind of a feeling here. You know, think for a minute, stop for a minute, you know, look around, look at you, what's going on, whatever. And of course, you know, a lot of the stuff, you know, with the first verse, I think it was, where he talks about, you know, the kids aren't playing on the streets anymore and all this stuff. And it is funny because he's saying this in 1986 when this was released, which is like almost 40 years ago from now. And it's just like, you know, so how things have changed even more since then. Because again, yeah, you're saying this in the late 80s. It's just like, obviously technology has, you know, gone even further. And, you know, I mean, today I would like to hear what, you know, the what the Housemartins would write about today on something like this. Because yeah, it's just from 86. Because again, you know, phones were definitely not what they are today. You know, like I said, you know, technology was not as far developed, obviously. It's just, so it's just interesting to hear this from 86, you know, this kind of standpoint. And I mean, yeah, this is same kind of thing. I mean, so many people, so many different older generations have always said, you know, from, you know, way back until, you know, when I'm old or whatever, it's going to be that kind of same kind of feeling, I think, where it's like, back in my day, you know, we played with dirt and sticks and all that stuff, whatever. But anyway, so that's just that kind of a sense comes to mind. But I also wanted to just talk about here with, obviously, the star of the video, Hugh Whitaker. Love him on the drums. Everything is so gentle, the gentle guitar playing. And of course, friggin', Fatboy Slim, of course. It's always so, it's just weird that, Fatboy Slim, of course, is on bass here. I think Norman Cook, isn't it, on bass? Yeah, of course, but better known now today is Fatboy Slim. It's just so weird, not weird, I guess, but it's just fun that he was in this band, you know, the bassist. Anyway, yeah, like I said, Stan Cullmore, of course, on guitar here. Beautiful, just slow guitar, slow bass. Everything is so, like I said, just kind of slow and tame, and really the star of the show here is Paul's, you know, beautiful vocals, which I love that they did that and kind of put it a lot on him. And and again, how Hugh and him just kind of had a fun little kind of back and forth of the video, where Hugh was trying to get in front of the camera and Paul's kind of like, what are you doing, whatever. And also at the end there, where Hugh was just kind of you know, it's just kind of a weird thing where he's just standing there, then Paul has to turn around and get him, and, you know, Hugh, we're done, mate. And it's just, I don't know, it's just such a fun little, I mean, it's so British, I mean, my God, so English. And yeah, I just love their play between that as well. But yeah, I mean, like I said, I mean, there's not much else you can really say, you know, except for the whole thing about, I mean, basically, you know, it's a decline in, I guess, the communities, the tight-knit communities that used to be are not what they used to be, whatever, they're not what they are anymore, basically. I mean, my God, I kind of butcher saying all that, but, you know, something's going on, a change is taking place. This is the lyrics, of course. Children smiling in the streets have all gone without a trace. The streets used to be full. It used to make me smile. And now it seems that everyone is walking single file. And of course, I can't, you know, overstate it. The way that Paul is delivering these lyrics is so beautiful. And many bow their heads in shame that used to hold them high. And those that used to say hello simply pass you by. So, you know, now nobody's saying hello. Nobody's saying anything. They're just walking, you know, single file. It's like, you know, they're zombies, whatever. And now it seems here Paul is kind of saying, you know, I told you so. And I think he does say that later on. You know, I'm the, you know, I saw this coming. I don't know how you guys didn't see it coming. And you know, second verse, I always said it could, they never thought it would. So there, one thing there, you know, one thing of like, I told you so. The people look so pitiful. I'm thinking that it should. And now it's almost here. Now it's on its way. I can't help saying told you so and have a nice final day. So this second verse here, I think it is the last verse before, you know, the chorus and pre-choruses take over. Yeah, it is. So it's like basically the last verse here. But, you know, that even puts even more kind of emphasis on the final line there. I can't help saying told you so and have a nice final day, not just nice day, nice final day. It seems a little cryptic, seems a little creepy, dark, obviously. A nice final day, you know, where he's even, you know, this song seems darker than it is. I mean, that's where I get that feeling of like, you know, hold the phone here, Heaton. You know, what are you saying? Have a nice final day of like, you know, because, you know, you're really longing for the old days now. Wait till it gets worse, you know, kind of a thing. So I just like kind of the crypticness of it. I guess that works. But again, I just like how the video is not as dark as the song seems to be. In the video, they're having so much fun. And the dance moves, I mean, it looks like they're on like a baseball field there or whatever. You know, the dance moves are impeccable. And again, I just love how Hugh is behind them and just kind of like, he seems like a robot, you know, doesn't know what's going on. Maybe he's a guy that they're talking about here, you know, not doing anything, not saying anything, and kind of like a robot, a zombie or something. I just thought that up. Maybe that's what's going on here with Hugh. But anyway, really enjoyed the song, really enjoyed Paul's voice. I mean, you can't say it enough. He was just stunning here. And again, to think for a minute, stop for a minute, the repetition of that, just to hammer that home, you know, just to say, again, you know, stop and think of what's going on around you, whatever, you know, how things are developing. And of course, there's going to be always people, like I said, that don't like, you know, the future or whatever, and long for the past. But I mean, for me anyway, you know, as somebody who's freaking 25, yes, that's what I am. Born in 98, it's just like, for me, it's just, I don't know those days really. I only know what I know. Which sounds kind of, you know, dumb to say. But yeah, so it's just like, I don't really long for the past, but of course there's many people who do. Because again, as somebody who was young, my past was what, in the early 2000s, the 2000s or whatever. It's just like, I was a kid, whatever. So anyway, I grew up, you know, in the future, you know, in the part of the world, because again, this was from 86. So it's just like, and you know, 1998, if you think, you know, from the way the song is saying and everything, things were even worse by 98, you know, compared to 86. So anyway, I don't know any other world, basically, is what I'm saying. So I just love, you know, hearing this, this kind of sentiment from the band. And yeah, just this kind of, feeling, you know, it's definitely kind of, different from Happy Hour, I guess. But even still with Happy Hour, they're still talking about, you know, being out with the bosses and, you know, trying to do this and that so you don't get fired and stuff. So I just love how, and even in that video, they're having fun too. But I just love how, you know, when a video is fun, the song is still not as fun as the video makes it seem. So that's what I've come to learn with the Housemartins through, I think, two songs. So anyway, I'll stop babbling now. Hopefully you understood some of that. But anyway, really enjoyed the performance here. I like the crypticness of it all. And I'm sure, yeah, many people watching can relate, you know, whatever. Like I said, I can't really because, you know, I'm so young and I don't know the olden days that he's talking about. But yeah, it's just, you know, back when simpler times were happening, that whole feeling. So anyway, thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, all that stuff. Really appreciate all the support. And I will talk to you guys again soon.